The Gruffalo's Child Storybook. The Gruffalo said that no Gruffalo should ever set foot in the deep, dark wood. Why not? Why not? Because if you do, the big, bad mouse will be after you. I met him once, said the Gruffalo. I met him a long, long time ago. What does he look like? Tell us, Dad. He have a big and heavy bag. I can't quite remember the Gruffalo said. Then he thought of a minute and scratched his head. His eyes are like pins. His eyes are like, his eyes are like pools of terrible fire, and his terrible whiskers are taller than the Gruffalo's child was feeling bored. The Gruffalo's child was feeling brave, so he tiptoed out of the Gruffalo's cave. The snow fell fast, and the wind blew wild into the woods. When the Gruffalo child, a trail in the snow. Who is this trail, and where does it go? Tail fox. Out of the log pole, how could this be the tail of the big bad mouse? You outslide the creek. Outside the creature, his eyes were small and he didn't have whiskers, no, none at all. You're not the mouse, not I, said the snake. He's down by the lake, picking the Gruffalo's cheek. The snow fell fast and the wind blew wild. I'm not scared, said the Gruffalo's child. Whose are these claw marks? Where do they go? Two eyes climbed up and out of the treetop house. Could this be the eyes of the big bad mouse? Down flew the creature. His tail was short and he didn't have whiskers of any sort. The snow came fast and the wind blew wild. "I'm not scared," said the buffalo child. "Oh ho ho! A track in the snow. Whose is this track and where does it go?" Whiskers at last in an underground house. Whiskers, could this be the home of the big bad mouse? The slunk. The creature's his eyes weren't fiery. His tail wasn't scaly. His tail, his whiskers weren't weary. "You're not the mouse." "Oh no, not me." "He's under the tree drinking buffalo. Buffalo tea." It's all a trick, said the buffalo shark, as she sat on a stump where the snow lay peeled. "I don't believe the big bad mouse." "But here comes a little mouse. One out of his house. You taste the good as a midnight feast." "Wait," said the mouse, "before you eat me. There's a friend of mine that you thought to meet him. If you let me hop into a hazel hole swing in on my friend so bad and big." Dun, dun, dun. The buffalo child would collected her first big, the big bad mouse. "So he does exist." The mouse hopped into the hazel tree. He beckoned, then said, "Just wait and see." Up came the moon. It was bright and round. A terrible shadow fell into the ground. this creature, so big, bad, and strong. His tail is his tail and his whiskers are terrible long. His ears are enormous. And over his shoulder, he carries a nut as big as a boulder. The big bad nose yelled, the Gruffalo child. The mouse jumped down from twing and smiled. Aha, ho, print in the snow. Whose are these footprints? Where do they go? The footprints lead to the Gruffalo's cave, where the Gruffalo's child was a bit less brave. The Gruffalo's child was a bit less bored and the Gruffalo snored and snored and snored. The end.